Hey everybody, Brian Garcia, meteorologist, National Weather Service, San Francisco Bay Area, Monterey Bay regions. Want to talk to you about a little bit of the weather that is coming our way this week. And I want to show you, start with the current satellite imagery here. So right here along the west coast, you can see a front coming through that's bringing some showers to Sonoma County, maybe some light rain up there. And then out here, a big area of low pressure that's ultimately going to go up into Alaska. But on the south side of this low, we're going to be looking at large wave generation. So that'll be to us midweek. So here's a current look at the radar as of about 3 p.m. Monday afternoon. Again, some light showers going through there. But what I really want to point out here is look at this. As we get through that system, and this is looking about 18, 19,000 feet up, you can see here over California, we get a big bump over the top of California. That's an area of high pressure that's really going to settle in over us for Wednesday and Thursday, with Thursday being the peak of that high pressure before Friday really starts to come in and move that high pressure out. And what that's going to do is bring us some heat. So you can see the heat risk here, mainly yellow across the region. Then Tuesday, yellow really spreads across the region. Then Wednesday, we end up with some orange spreading in, and Thursday, widespread orange. And this will also change as our forecast starts to refine. And then Friday, you can see back to a lot of yellow. So if we go back to Thursday here and we just click down in San Jose, for example, this is kind of what we're looking at right now. So it might be a little hard to read on your screen, but by the time we get to Wednesday, highs in the upper 80s, maybe even low 90s. And then Thursday, highs in the low 90s, maybe even mid 90s. And again, like typical, when we get our heat events up in the hills, it's going to remain warmer overnight because the air mass really just settles in overnight. And then during the day, we're going to reach into the 90s. There are some pockets and some models that are showing hundreds. So be ready for heat this week. Wednesday and Thursday are your hot days, even down to the coast, by the way, 70s into the 80s. Some parts of Santa Cruz could be into the 90s. So swell, we talked a little bit about open ocean swell right at the beginning there, and I just kind of want to hit this a little bit harder here. So I'm going to show you this picture. Let's see here. Looking about 48 hours out, this is wave period and direction. These are really long period swells. Whenever we get this long period swell, we see a lot of energy in the water, and we could end up seeing breaking waves on Thursday morning upwards of 20 to 30 feet. So this is going to be a very dangerous time as we get out into this time frame with the area of high pressure that's going to be sitting there over our area. And I'm just going to pull up this other map here and hold this. We're going to have this area of high pressure out over our region. So beautiful weather, and it's going to entice people to head to the beach. So I cannot emphasize enough, please, if you're going to the beach Wednesday or Thursday or Friday, especially those 3 days, be excessively cautious at the beach. The ocean could look calm from time to time, and then a big wave set can roll in and wash a lot farther up the beach. So in other words, know your tides, know what the surf's doing, sit there and pay attention from a good safe distance before you ever approach the sand, where you could potentially get knocked off your feet by a surging wave and swept into the ocean. It's a very dangerous week this week. But overall, I want you to take care of yourselves, make sure you take care of each other, and by all means, be good to each other. See everybody. Bye.